Welcome! Hello, I am Chris, and today we are going to discuss approaches to human intelligence.
What is intelligence? A symposium of 17 experts in the field on 1921 discussed the meaning of intelligence, came up with almost as many interpretations as there were experts present. Intelligence was variously described as the power of good responses from the point of view of truth or fact, the ability to carry on abstract thinking, involving two factors, the capacity for knowledge and the knowledge possessed.
This is Charles Spearman, an English engineer and army officer. On 1927, he proposed a theory named general factor or general intelligence. Spearman believed that general intelligence represents an intelligence factor underlying specific mental abilities. G factor acts as a central pool of energy that is required to perform a specific ability, such as mathematical, speaking, visual, and mechanical abilities. However, the Spearman's theory is questioned due to the lack of empirical basis and the processes described cannot be observed or be measured, though there is scores obtained by participants in measuring the G factor. Even so, Spearman is the first to actually use correlations as the raw upon which a theory of intelligence is based and led the studies on human intelligence. This is Louis Leon Thurston. According to him, intelligence, considered as a mental trait, is the capacity to make impulses focal at their early and finished stage of formation. Intelligence is therefore the capacity for abstraction, which is an inhibitory process.
Thurston concluded that there was not a single factor of intelligence, but a set of primary mental abilities. What was important in Thurston's early formation of his primary mental ability theory is that the abilities were described as independent, implying that you could be strong in one ability and very weak in another. This theory leads us to the next two theories which support the same idea.
This is Howard Gardner. On 1983, he suggests that intelligence cannot be quantified to digits as identified in IQ tests. He believed that the conventional concept of intelligence was too narrow and too restrictive, and that measures of IQ often miss out on the other intelligences. He also rejected the idea that there is a general ability that acts as a kind of super ability. Instead, there are several relatively independent intelligences. Gardner believes that human potential lies in the fact that people have a unique blend of capabilities and skills which he called intelligences. These intelligences include intrapersonal intelligence, logical mathematical intelligence, spatial visual intelligence, bodily kinesthetic intelligence, musical intelligence, verbal linguistic intelligence, existential intelligence, and naturalist intelligence. This is Robert Sternberg. On 1985, he proposed triargic theory. In analytical thinking, we try to solve familiar problems by using strategies that manipulate the elements of a problem or the relationship among the elements, such as comparing and analyzing. In creative thinking, we try to solve new kinds of problems that requires us to think about a problem and its elements in a new way, such as inventing and designing. In practical thinking, we try to solve problems that apply what we know to everyday contexts, such as applying and using. Sternberg proposed that intelligence comprises three aspects: dealing with the relation of intelligence to the internal world of the person, to experience, and to the external world. He then elaborated to the information processing in three different kinds of components. First, metacomponents. It is the person's higher-order executive processes used to plan, monitor, and evaluate problem-solving. Second is performance component. Lower order processes used for implementing the commands of the meta components. And lastly, knowledge acquisition component, the processes used for learning how to solve the problems in the first place. Components are highly interdependent. Meta components activates performance and knowledge acquisition components, which in turn provide feedback to the meta components. In practice, the three kinds of components do not function in isolation. Like the multiple intelligence theory of Gardner, triargic theory is also criticized due to its unempirical nature. That's all. Thank you for watching.